just discuss about how to prepare the culture media. So before getting into the details of how to prepare this culture media, let us know what is meant by this media, why do we require this media and how it is prepared. So how can we define the culture media? It is nothing but simply I can define it as a substrate which will support the growth of the microorganisms, or we can define it as the combination of all the nutrients which are required for the growth of the microorganisms. It is a combination of the nutrients which will require for the growth of the microorganisms. And why do we require this culture media? As we all know that microorganisms are nutritionally diversified in nature. Each microorganism requires a specific nutrients for their maximum growth in that culture media. So we need to prepare the media which will support the growth of these microorganisms, which is having the perfect nutrients in that particular medium. Then only it can support the growth of the microorganisms. So we should prepare an ideal culture media which will support the growth of the microorganisms. What do you mean by ideal culture media? Which will be having the nutrients required for the growth of the microorganism. Basically, a culture media consists of the nutrients the source of nitrogen it should have, the source of carbon it should have, as well as the mineral salts and the growth factors along with the distilled water. Okay, so these are considered as the common ingredients or the common requirements for the growth of the microorganisms. So today we'll just look into few examples. So first let us go with the nutrient agar. So nutrient agar is nothing but the which is considered as a basic or the simple media, because it consists of only simple nutrients which will be commonly used for the growth of the especially the bacterial cultures. Okay, please remember the nutrient agar medium will be used to grow the non-fastidious bacteria. So what do you mean by this non-fastidious bacteria? There are two types, fastidious as well as non-fastidious bacteria or the microorganisms. Non-fastidious bacteria are nothing but which doesn't require any specific nutrients to be included in the culture medium. They will grow comfortably when we supply the basic nutrients which are required for the growth of the microorganisms. So the nutrient agar comes under that example, which is considered the basic or simple medium which will be mostly used for the growth of the non-fastidious microorganisms, especially the bacteria. Now coming to the composition. So as I said, each and every culture media should have the source of nitrogen, carbon, mineral salts along with the growth factors, and the if we want to go with the solid media, definitely we need to add the solidifying agent, that is agar, or if not, if we exclude the agar, it will become the liquid media. So before starting this media, let us go with the history of the culture media. So the credit goes to the Louis Pasteur, who had first used the simple liquid media, that I think meat extract. So he is the first person who used the liquid media for the first time to grow the microorganisms. Later on, Robert Koch has been given the importance of the solid media for the growth of the microorganisms, because by using the solid media only we can know the or we can identify the specific microorganism based upon the colony morphology, which we couldn't get it from the liquid media. Now coming to the composition of the nutrient agar, it is made up of peptone, NaCl, beef extract, distilled water and agar. Okay, now coming to the peptone, it is nothing but it consists of the enzymatic digest of the protein. So it is acting as a source of nitrogen. Peptone is acting as a source of nitrogen, whereas beef extract is a source of carbohydrates as well as the vitamins. Okay, now coming to the NaCl, this will be regulate the osmotic balance or maintain the pH of the culture media. NaCl is used to maintain the specific pH of the culture media. And one more thing you need to remember, whenever we are prepare in the culture media, we should check the pH before giving for the sterilization, because each and every microorganism will grow at an appropriate or optimum pH value only. So pH plays a very important role during the preparation of the medium. So before giving for autoclave, we need to check the pH of the particular medium. So this pH will be maintained by the NaCl, which have been added during the preparation of the culture media. Now, as I said, agar-agar will be used as a solidifying agent, and the unique feature of this agar is, as I said, it will be acting as the solidifying agent, and it does not have any nutritive value. Please remember, it does not have any nutritive value, does not act as a source of carbon, nitrogen or anything. So it doesn't have any nutritive value, and it is not utilized by the microorganism. That is another unique feature. The agar-agar is a solidifying agent which does not have the nutritive value, as well as it is not used up by the microorganisms. Okay, and whatever the agar-agar we are using, it has been extracted from the seaweed or the red algae. So like this, we can go with the composition of the nutrient agar. Now coming, and when you look at the distilled water, why we are using the distilled water? So that whatever the components we are adding, they get dissolved in that distilled water. Okay, and the agar mostly will go with the 2%, 2 grams per 100 ml, or accordingly you can calculate. Now coming to how to prepare the nutrient agar. So weigh individual ingredients separately. And suspend them in 1000 ml of distilled water. Okay, and we need to gently heat those components so that each and every nutrients will get dissolved in the distilled water. After that, we need to give for autoclave, where it will be done at 121 degrees centigrade for 15 minutes. And then after cooling, we need to pour into them. We need to pour the media into the sterile petri plates. So like that, we can go for the preparation of the nutrient agar. Okay, I hope this is clear with the nutrient agar. Now coming to the next agar medium, that is blood agar. So blood agar comes under the example of enriched media. Enriched media is nothing but where we are enriching the media by adding a special nutrient to that media. For suppose here, you can see the composition. It is similar to the nutrient agar, except the blood. Here we are using the sheep blood. So that means this is acting as the special nutrient which enhances the growth of particular type of microorganism. Okay. So what are the uses of the blood agar? So when you compare with the nutrient agar, it is used to grow the non-fastidious bacteria, whereas blood agar is used to grow the fastidious microorganisms. As I already said, fastidious is nothing but which will require a special component or nutrient to be included in the media. So here, what is the special nutrient? That is nothing but the blood. Okay, so this blood agar will be used to grow the pathogen or microorganisms like Neisseria and Streptococcus species. Please remember. Okay. Now also, this blood agar is also used to differentiate the streptococcal species based upon the property of hemolysis. We can differentiate. Looking at the uses of the blood agar, as I said, it is used to grow the fastidian microorganisms like Neisseria and Streptococcus species, as well as it is used to differentiate the within the streptococcal species depending upon the hemolysis property. So I'll discuss it later. First we'll just get into the details on how to prepare this blood agar. The same thing how we had prepared the nutrient agar, the same thing we need to do, but after according to the composition, it is made up of peptone, lactose, bile salts, NaCl, neutral red, crystal violet, distilled water, and again we need to pH. So maintain the pH at 7.2. Okay. And now coming to the composition, peptone already we know it is acting as a source of nitrogen, and lactose here, as I said, it is used to differentiate lactose and non-lactose fermenting bacteria. So that's why the lactose, the ability of the bacteria to ferment this lactose or the carbohydrate could be judged by adding the lactose to the media. Okay. Now, I mean the bile salts and the crystal violet. Bile salts and the crystal violet, these components will inhibit the unwanted bacteria. So what are the unwanted bacteria here? They will not allow the gram-positive bacteria to grow on the surface of the Meconium agar. Okay. Bile salts and the crystal violet will not allow the growth of the gram-positive microorganisms. Now coming to the neutral red. So this neutral red will be changing its color when there is a deviation in the pH of the medium. Anyway, we are maintaining a specific pH, but after growth of the bacteria, specific type of bacteria, you can see there is a pH variation. That variation can be detected by the change in the color of the medium, which can be done by the neutral red. Okay, and NaCl, anyway, we know that to maintain the pH of the medium. Okay, so weigh all these ingredients separately, dissolve them in the distilled water or suspend them in the distilled water, heat it, and then give for sterilization. After cooling, we can pour it in the petri plates. Okay, so coming to the uses, as I said, it is used to differentiate lactose and non-lactose fermenting bacteria. How to differentiate? Because here lactose means these lactose fermenting bacteria has the ability to ferment the lactose, and these will appear as pink color colonies on the surface of the Meconium agar, whereas non-lactose fermenting bacteria will be observed as translucent colonies on the surface of the Meconium agar. So what do you mean by this? So whenever there is a fermentation of the lactose has been occurred, definitely production of acid will be there. Due to that production of acid, environment around the colony, the pH around that colony will be reduced because there is a production of acid. So that's why there is a reduction of pH, you can see the change in the color of the medium. So that's why we are saying it as lactose fermenting will form the pink colonies due to the pH variation or due to the production of the acid. Whereas non-lactose, it just doesn't have any ability of fermenting the lactose. So therefore, there is no production of the acid. There is no color change. So that's why we can observe that as the transparent or translucent.